you're not Greek. Why do you have Greek mythology? And I'm like, because I f***ing like it.
What is good, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. My name is Justin, and you guys are here with JustInKD. Now, I did a video not too long ago talking about all the cons that has to do with tattoos and getting them done. Then I did a video talking about all the pros and why I believe that the pros will always outweigh the cons. Now I'm coming at to you guys with another con video. And I'm sure you're wondering, Justin, why you want to do another video? Didn't you cover it all enough in that last one? And you're right, I covered a lot, but you guys left such great comments in terms of experiences, opinions in that video that I felt it was only right and it was needed to make another video. So I hope you guys enjoy this. If you guys are new to the channel, I do want to welcome you. In this channel, we pretty much talk about all things that are tattoo related, my experience, opinions in certain topics, but most importantly, my journey towards getting amazing tattoos and working towards an awesome bodysuit. Now, I have some great news. I have booked another point with my artist, Brandon. We have been killing the lower leg sleeve, but he has recently sent me a makeup of what the upper thigh is going to look like, and you guys do not want to miss this. It's incredible, and I cannot wait to show you guys what we have planned. So go ahead, subscribe, join the community, but let's get to today's video. Let's see some more cons that I have to do with tattoos. Let's go. Now, like I mentioned in my last video about cons, there are many things that you must take into consideration when planning and getting a tattoo. Now, majority and 99% of the time, for me at least, I believe that the pros will always outweigh the cons. But there again, there are things that you must consider. Like, again, look at me. I have two full sleeves. I'm working towards like a full leg sleeve and I'm going towards that bodysuit. So for me, they will always win. But there are always things that you must take into consideration, and this video is just adding on to those things that you got to think about. I would recommend that you guys go and watch that last con video I did, and then go watch the pro video I did as well after this, and kind of get a better understanding and then see for yourself. But I want you guys to go ahead and comment right now, right off the bat, like usual, and let me know if there's any of the biggest cons that you kind of consider or see with tattoos and see if they match up with this new list. But more importantly, do you now think that the pros still outweigh the cons, or now do you think the cons are starting to outweigh the pros because there's so many? Now, a couple cons that I'm going to kind of refresh your memory from the last video I did were that they are permanent. You are going to be judged by society. They're going to hinder some job opportunity that you might want to get into, you know, chasing a dream or kind of a vision or happiness that you might not potentially ever reach, and many, many more. But again, this video is not meant to kind of scare anybody off that wants tattoos or wants to get a tattoo, but just to help better inform you and get a better understanding of the things that will come into play. And again, these are a lot of the things in this video are mentioned from other people's experiences and opinions, and not just mine. I kind of resonated with those and I felt I had to include them as well. And also, I also went and asked my Instagram followers and I did a question, and they all replied back to it about what the cons are for them with tattoos. So you'll see stuff pop out throughout this whole video on other people's opinions and not just mine, so we can get a better understanding and outlook of the cons that have to deal with tattoos in part two. So I touched on this one in my last video, and it was more towards, you know, questions in terms of the grading questions, like, what do you do for a living? Have you been to jail? Stupid questions like that where they expect a low answer. This kind of con is, you know, they're still questions, but they're more repetitive and annoying questions. You know, I'm going to tell you right now, if you have a good piece of artwork on you or you have a whole sleeve, you are going to get asked all the time, how much was it? Where did you get it done? How long did it take? And then also, you know, does it have any meaning? And then when you tell them sometimes that a tattoo or that tattoo doesn't have any meaning and you just got it because you like it, you know, then they look at you weird, and then you got to spend that whole time explaining to them the reason behind the tattoo in some way of why you got it, why you like it, and they just look at you weird. Or you got to explain to them the cost of a tattoo and why you feel you paid a good amount for that piece even though they don't understand. So it's like these questions get annoying and repetitive. I can't tell you how many times I'm asked these on a weekly basis. And, you know, as much as I understand that people are kind of just curious and want to know, it does get annoying. It does take a bit of time out of your day. So just watch out for that and know that that is a con and that other people kind of experience that as well from the comments. So the next con that I got is being overcautious. And I kind of touched base on this in the last video of the cons. And that was, you know, talking about going to the beach and having to wear sunscreen, avoiding the sun, avoiding tanning beds. You know, you become more cautious in that kind of sense. But this one, you become very, very cautious in everyday things. You're a lot more scared now of, you know, just the sun, scratches, scars, you know, just rubbing up against something.
you know, your thought process is a lot more on your tattoo and how to make sure that it is staying safe. Like, I'll tell you an example for me. Well, I got two actually. One is driving, and you know, you got your hand out the window and the sun just beating down on it, and you don't really notice that or think anything of it, but that tattoo is fading in a way because the sun's beating down on it. And so now I always stick my arm in the shade under where it can't get hit. And then also another one is, like, I used to work on my car all the time. I would stick my hand in the engine bay and do whatever, and I would come up with scratches all the time. Now I'm very careful in terms of what I do and how I put my arm in, because I don't want, you know, a scratch on my arm to potentially ruin it. Now, most of the time, and I will say 90% of the time, you will be fine. But these things do kind of come into play and kind of come into your thought process in terms of what you do, and choose now what you do in your everyday lifestyle, because now, again, you are more cautious on how you do things. Now, the next con I'm going to list is being judged. And I mentioned this in my last video, but I'm going to kind of take a different kind of turn on this one. And that is, you're going to be judged a lot on the style that you have and the theme that you have. And what I mean by this is, say you have, say, a Greek mythology sleeve. Somebody's going to come up to you and say, oh, are you Greek? And when you say no, they're going to judge you and say, why? You're not allowed to have that. You're not Greek. Or, like, you know, what's even worse, Japanese. You'll have a Japanese piece or sleeve, and they'll ask, and they're like, you're not Japanese. I can tell by what, you're white or you're black, and why you have a Japanese? Like, you're not allowed to have that. Tribal, you're not Aztec, you're not Samoan, you're not Polynesian, you're not Hawaiian. So it's like, all these things, people are going to pick on you because, you know, that background doesn't fit that theme or that style of the tattoo that you wear. And, you know, it's totally fine to get whatever kind of tattoo you want. It's your form of self-expression. Don't let somebody kind of just say, well, you're not that, so you can't get that. It's, again, whatever you want, but be ready, because I've had people say, you're not Greek. Why do you have Greek mythology? And I'm like, because I fucking like it. And then also another thing I kind of got to mention as well, and this is huge, and this is not being judged by society. It's being more judged on your family. Family is going to be the number one, I think, people that are going to judge you the most, because I feel like they almost feel like they're obligated because they know you more. They've seen you all your life, and they feel like they can tell you whatever the hell they want. So they are going to judge you the most out of anybody. And it sucks to feel, because, you know, those are the people you really want to have kind of comfort from. And instead, you kind of just get ridiculed for them. I'm lucky where I've had most of my family be, you know, positive of my tattoos, thankfully. But, you know, a lot of people out there have said family are very negative on their tattoos. And that is a big con as well. Now, this next con was left from a subscriber, and I feel like I need to include it just because I kind of resembled with it and understood where she was coming from. But I want you guys also to let me know in the comments if you agree with this con, if it is a con, or if you don't and you disagree. What she said was that, you know, your tattoos almost become like an accessory to you, and it's an everyday accessory. So now you got to kind of choose clothing and, you know, styles and pieces to kind of suit and kind of go together with that new look that you have. Some pieces may not go together, and you cannot get that kind of piece that you want to wear because it clashes with the tattoo that you have or the style that you already kind of wear with you on your tattoos. I do agree with her. I can see where she's coming from on this. But let me know in the comments if you guys agree or you disagree. I would love to know on this one. So the next con is a pretty big one, and I'm surprised I missed this one in my last video. And that is that, you know, tattoos will almost cover all definition in terms of muscle, in terms of your body. You know, I'm going to tell you right now, I did a video a while back where I went and I got makeup and I covered both my sleeves, and we were able to see, once those were covered, the amount of definition in terms of my, you know, the cuts, the striation, how much all that came back when I covered it all up. So when you put tattoos onto the skin, you know, it changes how you look. And if you're somebody that loves to work out, and, you know, it's a great stimulus to, like, see and, like, you physically have, like, a cut to know that you've been doing good in terms of working out, eating healthy, to get a tattoo and have that covered up is kind of, it does kind of hurt a bit. I remember when I had mine done, you know, it hurt for the first couple weeks to not see those cuts that you took so much pride in. You know, for everybody out there that is big on bodybuilding or is big on how they look, they like to see those cuts, those striations. If you get a tattoo, and especially if you get a sleeve, get ready for all that to kind of go away and be covered, because you will not see it as well. Now, the next con is pretty simple, but it's also a pretty big one, and that is, you don't have enough space. I can't tell you how nervous I am to know that, you know, I'm going to run out of space eventually, and I want to try to get as much as I can on me and whatever I want, but I also got to make sure that, you know, the sizing's right, the placement's right. So, you know, you might have to sacrifice some pieces because you don't have enough space on you. And now I know you're thinking, like, Justin, I'm not trying to get a bodysuit like you, so I'm going to have tons of space still. But, you know, there's a lot of people that still just try to go for a sleeve look, and, you know, you run out of space on the arm because there's only a certain amount of space there that you're able to kind of put on and where things will fit. So you really got to watch out and know that, you know, there's only a certain amount of stuff you can do in that kind of area. And if you are going towards that bodysuit, you will probably run out of skin eventually. And there's nothing really you can do about it. It's just something that's going to be, once it's done, it's covered, it's covered. Now, this next con is kind of silly, but I felt need to be included because so many of you wrote in saying this, and I really do feel the same way. And that is itchiness. The goddamn itchiness is so bad sometimes. It sucks because you can't itch it. It's going to destroy your tattoo if you itch it. So you gotta slap it. And slapping only helps for a little bit of time before that itchiness and that feeling comes back. And especially if you're in public and you don't want to slap yourself because then you just look like an insane kind of person. Also, the aftercare. You know, there's a lot of things that you have to take into consideration with the aftercare process of a tattoo and healing it. A lot of it's on you, so it becomes very stressful. You know, washing it 3 times a day for the first like 3 days, 4 days, moisturizing, applying healing ointment, making sure you're not scratching up against anything or rubbing up against anything. No dog hair. You can't sleep on it too much. You got to take showers, quick showers. You can't go swimming. You can't go to the beach. You can't go in the sun because that's going to sting. You know, all those things. I just listed them all off the top of my head. And those things all become very stressful. Now, I do have something that can kind of throw all that out the window, including the itchiness, and that is using Saniderm. Saniderm is one of my favorite products just because, you know, it takes away all that itchiness. It takes away all that care in terms of, you know, you just leave it on, and for 7 days, you don't have to worry. And then that whole point and that whole period of main kind of healing is done and over with. So I definitely recommend you go check out Saniderm, and I do have a 10% off code right here. It'll be linked in the description for you to go check out. But also, I do that weekly giveaway of Saniderm. And all you got to do to participate in that is like the video, show that you're subscribed, and then send me a screenshot to my Instagram. And on the following Monday, I do a live giveaway on my Instagram. And then I choose your name out, I send it to you, and you can enjoy it on your next tattoo. But I definitely, definitely recommend this piece and this product because it throws this whole con pretty much out the door. Now, guys, I want you guys to go ahead and comment and let me know if there were any cons that I've missed. I am pretty sure after this second video that I have covered them all. But I've learned from you guys that there are some people out there that feel one way and, you know, can resonate with another. So go ahead and let me know if I missed any cons that you think should be included in maybe a third video by chance. But I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe again because I got an amazing tattoo coming soon, which you do not want to miss. And then like the video again for support and then participate in that giveaway because then you've already done all that. So you may as well, you may win something. And like always, Justin out.